The Sony press conference at this year's E3 gave us a whole lot of exciting content to digest, including some new epic gameplay footage from the upcoming Spider-Man PS4 game. It featured Spidey swinging through the raft in pursuit of Electro, as the supervillain unleashed the likes of many of the web-slinger's other foes, and other villains within the maximum security prison. It then ended off with a major cliffhanger too. Surrounded by members of some of the hero's greatest villains, Spider-Man proceeds to fight them off, but ultimately can't handle the barrage of attacks. Knocked down to the ground, he then looks up to someone and says, "Wait, you?" with the trailer cutting to the title card immediately afterwards. So a lot of people were wondering, just who was Spidey talking to? But now it seems like that character's identity has finally been revealed. So for context, the initial theory was that this was a member of the Sinister Six, the supervillain group in the comics that features some of the most powerful villains of Peter Parker's rogue gallery. The original Six consisted of Vulture, Electro, Kraven the Hunter, the original Mysterio, Sandman, and was led by Dr. Octopus. That being said, the group has fluctuated over the years in terms of its members, so having the iteration of Mr. Negative, Electro, Rhino, Scorpion, and the Vulture in this game isn't anything shocking. But people wanted to know who that character that Spidey spoke to was. Like, really badly. Since it was a bit of a Julius Caesar et tu Brute moment, some believed it could have been Harry Osborn's Green Goblin. But others firmly believed that it would be Dr. Octopus, since he's typically the leader of the Sinister Six and the character who started the group in the first place. A video recently surfaced which featured Chris J. Alex, the actor portraying Rhino in the game, talking with YouTuber Drifter at E3. In the video, he's describing a fight scene, although doesn't specify which one. But he does state, I quote, "The fight scene was particularly hard. Everyone is scaled differently. Dr. Octopus is really tall, Rhino is big." The video has since been taken down, but Eurogamer managed to find a clip of it which has made its way back up onto YouTube.
But it was, the fight scene was particularly hard because everyone's scaled differently. You know, Dr. Octopus is really tall. Rhino is big.
So as you can imagine, theories about the game's plot have exploded online ever since. One of the most plausible ones suggests that we may have a story with some semblance to the Superior Spider-Man arc from the comics, when Otto Octavius switches bodies with Spider-Man, leading to Spidey's death while he assumes the role of Peter Parker and Spider-Man, making some memorable improvements to his suit. This could be a feasible explanation for Miles Morales' presence in the game, potentially taking Peter's place, which was teased at last year's E3 when the character appeared at the end of the trailer. Now it's worth noting that the universe that the game is set in is not one of the ones from the Marvel comics, nor is it set within the MCU. With the recent revelation that the Avengers Tower is present in the game, there has been speculation that this Spider-Man game will be opening the door for a whole universe of superhero games featuring Marvel characters. There has been no news that Avengers characters will interact with you in the game, but recently more news of iconic buildings that are associated with other Marvel characters have been popping up. Images of Doctor Strange's Sanctum Sanctorium have surfaced, and in press materials handed out at E3, an ad was spotted for Nelson and Murdoch Attorneys at Law, confirming that Matt Murdoch, Daredevil, does in fact exist in this universe. The big question is whether or not any of these characters will interact with Spider-Man, or if all these are just Easter eggs, potentially setting the stage for other Insomniac Marvel titles. It's hard to say, considering Marvel's marketing strategies with the MCU have proven incredibly successful, so a video game franchise isn't totally absurd. Other Marvel characters that have been revealed or implied to exist in the game's universe include Wilson Fisk, aka Kingpin, Norman Osborn as the mayor of New York City, and Black Cat. Alright, so what do you guys think? Is Dr. Octopus the villain that was teased to us in this E3, or do you think that it's someone else entirely? Let us know your thoughts in those comments below. If you guys want to know more about the spotting of the Avengers Tower in the game, be sure to click on the video currently flashing on your screen. And be sure to subscribe to Top 10 Gaming for all the news, updates, highlights, and lists about all the biggest video games in the industry. Thanks for watching, everybody.